What's up guys, it's Tommy here and welcome to a football news video where we will talk about Chelsea being banned for two transfer windows from signing or registering any players by the FIFA disciplinary committee. They signed as many as 29 young players illegally breaching the FIFA, you know, code of conduct, and that is a huge news because Chelsea are already in crisis, in turmoil. Their results have been pretty awful. They lost to Man United very recently and they are out of the FA Cup. They lost to Man City 6-0, they lost to Bournemouth 4-0. But what do you think about this this news? What do you think about Chelsea being banned for two whole transfer window? They have been found guilty of breaching rules about signing minors by FIFA, and also they have been fined for £460,000, which is not like an awful lot of money. But also the FA, the Football Association, the English FA, has been fined £390,000, and both parties will appeal this decision. And I think in hindsight, this is why they signed Christian Pulisic in the January transfer window, but they loaned him back to Dortmund. So I did some research about this, and Christian Pulisic's signing is not affected by this because he has been already signed by Chelsea. But the big question is, was Pulisic registered already as a Chelsea player or not? Because if he's not registered, he under this new ban, he might not be able to be registered by Chelsea for next season. And also, if Eden Hazard goes to Real Madrid, which is heavily rumored, and he might want to leave the sinking ship of Chelsea Football Club, they might be in serious trouble. They might find themselves in the position of Arsenal, where they have to rebuild their squad. They have a lot of aging players. And also, if they can't sign players for two whole transfer windows, that is massive. So FIFA have given the club 90 days to rectify the situation concerning the players signed, and Chelsea say that they categorically refute the findings of the FIFA disciplinary committee and will therefore be appealing the decision. So the big question is, if this appeal goes to the Court of Arbitration of Sports, will Chelsea be able to sign players until the appeal process is ongoing? Because if they do, then they might go crazy in the summer transfer window because they have no other option. They might have that 1 month open window where they have to sign players basically for the full 1 year ahead, and clubs will know this, and every club that will be approached by Chelsea, they might slap a £20 million bonus or a £20 million price hike on the original transfer fee that Chelsea was about to pay. So Chelsea are banned until July 2020. And I think Chelsea were already in trouble because they already needed a rebuilding job. And also their owner, Roman Abramovich, is banned from entering the UK. And the Chelsea funding has been dried up a little bit, especially, you know, since Roman Abramovich has had trouble with the English authorities. And I think this leaves Chelsea in a very, very dangerous position. They can't keep sacking manager after manager, but if they sack Mauricio Sarri, and there is a heavy rumor going around in the football newspapers that if Chelsea lose the League Cup final, they will sack Mauricio Sarri. But which manager, and especially which top manager, will want to join a club who will not be able to sign players for one whole year, two transfer windows? If it was just one transfer window, the summer transfer window, I would dismiss this as not so important. But to have two transfer windows, and of course Chelsea are able to sell players, they are allowed to sell players, which means that Eden Hazard still might go to Real Madrid. But Chelsea will now be, I think, extremely reluctant to sell any of their star players, any of their top players, but we shall wait and see. So what are the regulations that Chelsea breached? Let's look at this in detail. So FIFA regulations prohibit the international transfer of players under 18 unless in a very specific circumstances not related to football. So players aged over 16 are permitted to move within the European Union, providing set criteria are met. The regulations are in place for safeguarding purposes to protect children, which I think is fair. In January 2016, it was reported that there were suspecting irregularities in the recruitment of Chelsea's Bernard Traoré, who now plays for Olympique Lyon in France. Traoré officially joined Chelsea on January the 1st, 2014, signing a four-year deal on the first day of the transfer window opening following his 18th birthday, September 6th, 2013. However, he had appeared as a trialist on the July 2013 preseason tour, and pictures emerged of him playing in the Chelsea under 18 team in October 2011 in an apparent breach of FIFA regulations. So in October 2011, Bertrand Traoré was like 16 years old, and unless it's not for footballing reasons, so unless Bernard Traoré's family moved to London for other reasons and not football, so for another business, another job maybe that the parents took on, they are not allowed to sign players. And that was just one case, and imagine, Bernard Traoré was just one of 29 players. 29! That's like almost three whole football teams whose signing resulted in the sanction. So Chelsea didn't sign one or two young players breaching the rules. They signed 29 players. That is a lot. And I don't understand how it took 29 young players for Chelsea to sign, for FIFA to wake up and slap them with this transfer ban. And Chelsea said that 63 of 92 cases did not amount to breaches and expressed disappointment at the FIFA disciplinary committee's findings, and of course they will appeal. But still, something is not right when players as young as 14, 15, 16 years old are signing for English clubs, and I include all English clubs in here just for the money, because at that point a football's career is still in its infancy, and I just can't see how that is right. Many people are debating how much will this affect Chelsea and their playing squad, because Chelsea have like three teams worth of players out on loan, so they can recall a whole host of loan players for next season. The big question is, how good are they? Are their loan players? How good are they? Will they really help the squad, or will they keep them on the same level? They definitely will have enough players to compete. There's no question. The big question is, will they have enough, good enough players to compete for the Champions League? I think Chelsea can forget competing for the Premier League title for the foreseeable future, at least for the next two or three years, and whatever manager they stick with, and I think they should stick with Sarri, because look at Pep Guardiola's first season. It was quite similar to Chelsea's current season in that the play was very inconsistent. But if Sarri is a world-class manager, in my opinion, and Chelsea should give him more time. But you know how Chelsea as a football club are. They sack any manager at the first sign of losing some games, at the first sign of failure. I mean, they sacked Carlo Ancelotti, who won the double the previous season, and that still he was sacked. They sacked Roberto Di Matteo, who won the Champions League with Chelsea the following season. So Chelsea are a club who are not messing about. They want instant success, and some journalists are saying that is Chelsea's downfall, But if you just take a look at the trophies won and how Chelsea's last 10 years have panned out, you can't really argue that Chelsea's method has been successful. It's not a traditional method, it's not a conventional method. In England, you know, most football clubs give time to managers, most like really big football clubs. Look at Arsenal, look at Manchester United, look at Liverpool, but look at Tottenham as well. But Chelsea are not like that. Chelsea want instant success, and they are sacking managers left, right and center. They basically appoint on average more than one manager per season, which is crazy. It's mind-blowing. Like, how can you expect to have prolonged success and a good strategy? But it has worked so far for Chelsea, I have to say. I can't deny their results. They have won the Premier League title four times in the past, like 15 years, and or was it four or five times? I think they won it twice with Mourinho, and then they won it with Mourinho again. Ancelotti also won a league title. Antonio Conte also won a league title. So yeah, five or more Premier League titles has been won by Chelsea in the past few seasons. So you can't really argue with their method. But still, I think Maurizio Sarri, they would be crazy to sack him as early as this. I think at least give him until the summer. And then, you know, if they don't get top four, then maybe they are justified to sack the manager. And Ross Barkley said that you should give time to the Chelsea manager Maurizio Sarri. You will see how good Sarri ball will be. That's what Barkley said. Barkley also said that Sarri tries to improve every player throughout his career. You can see at Napoli how well he did with the players he had, how well he improved them. You can see on the training pitch a lot of things improving in each individual. We went through a bit of an up and down spell in the last couple of weeks, but we are confident that we will come through it and achieve success. So that's what Ross Barkley said. But I think this game against Manchester City, the Carabao Cup final, which will be played today, is absolutely massive. It's crucial for Chelsea's season. They can't lose by three or more goals against Man City. And I think if they win, that will galvanize their season, and maybe that will help them to finish in the top four. But Manchester United look very, very strong. And I will preview the Manchester United-Liverpool game later today, so stay tuned for that. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. See you later, guys. Goodbye.